This video is another proof that Jaggi Vasudev plagiarizes the works of Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha, who is also known as Palani Swami. We will be able to clearly see the fact of plagiarism by Jaggi by the end of this clip. The story that Jaggi Vasudev tells to his audience that he didn't study anything and all his knowledge came to him as a result of his pulp fiction enlightenment is just a cover-up. As a matter of fact, Jaggi Vasudev has been flicking information from the lecture notes and books of Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha, who is also known as Palani Swami. And it is this wisdom of Palani Swami that made Jaggi Vasudev so popular. So, let's explore striking similarities between the explanations given on Om by Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha and Jaggi Vasudev. Here I'm going to show you the lecture on Om by Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha, who is also known as Palani Swami, that I heard when I first joined the Sri Kali Ashram in Thailand. That was in 2007. This and many other lectures were given by Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha, who is also known as Palani Swami, to his Western students as an introduction to the world of spirituality. At that time, unfortunately, there was no video recording facilities. It is an audio recording of the lecture that I am going to share with you. So let's explore.
Om is made up of three letters. So A plus U plus M, according to the mathematics of Sanskrit, becomes Om, O-M. Now Om is known as the mantra, the basis of all mantras, yeah? The basis of all reality. Om is the essence, the entire consciousness that is the essence of the fabric of creation, the fabric of everything. Do you understand what I'm saying? Om is the basis of everything. Like oxygen, aerobic and anaerobic creatures. For aerobic creatures, oxygen is a vital component. Without oxygen, there is no survival. You just have to hold your nose for a while and you'll be finished. You know? So like that. For anaerobic animals, there is no need, even if I hold the nose, it can still survive because there is no oxygen needed. So Om is like that. Om is underlying essence. Put it as underlying essence, you will understand better. And essence of all, everything, you know. So as I said, Om is a very old notion. It is in all the Vedas. I always say all the Vedas because the Vedas are the oldest living written legacies of the this world. There's nothing earlier, no other material earlier than the Vedas. This is the only legacy that is left in mankind. And then you will see Om is also in other literatures. In Christianity, it's what? Amen? Amen? How do you say it?
Amen.
Amen? Amen. Yeah. The same idea of Om that is practiced in Islam, it is Amen. So Om is not peculiar to just India. You know, it is a universal concept. It is not just in India that you find Om. You find in the Middle East, you find everywhere. Even the Chinese have this idea of Om. The Buddhists also use Om. Yeah, Om and the Om. Yeah? So everyone uses this concept in the ancient world. So Om was understood to be this basis of creation.
This lecture gives a clear example of how a true guru should talk. One can clearly see from this very small piece of the recorded lecture the depth of the knowledge and the uniqueness of Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha's understanding and presentation of the topic. Nobody else before Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha, who is also known as Palani Swami, had spoken about the parallels between Om, Amen, Amin, and so on. And once again, I would like to say that these lectures I heard back in 2007, when I just joined the ashram. Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha, who is also known as Palani Swami, has been teaching traditional Tantra and Yoga to Western students for the past 20 years. Before that, he taught spiritual science to his Indian students. So Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha's overall teaching experience comes to over 40 years. Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha is a traditionally educated, initiated Shaiva Agama teacher. He is fluent in Sanskrit, Tamil, Hindi, English, and few other non-Indian languages. Altogether, he can speak 14 foreign languages. Now, let's examine Jaggi Vasudev's background.
I have always avoided learning Sanskrit language.
Here, Jaggi Vasudev is publicly saying that he doesn't know and he doesn't want to know Sanskrit.
I'm completely spiritually uneducated.
Here, Jaggi Vasudev states that he is spiritually uneducated.
I have never studied any spirituality, if you don't believe this.
Here, Jaggi Vasudev states that he never studied any spirituality.
That's the way I am. That's the only thing I know, which is 100% energy work. No other things, no mantras, no tantras, no nothing.
In this clip, Jaggi Vasudev states that he doesn't know any tantra or mantra.
So a mantra is significant for its sound. Meaning is meaningless. Meaning is just made up by us.
In this clip is getting even more interesting. Jaggi Vasudev, having previously stated that he doesn't know Sanskrit, that he doesn't know any tantra or mantra, here Jaggi Vasudev has an audacity to say that mantra has no meaning and that meaning is something that is made up by us. With all this in mind, let's see what Jaggi Vasudev is saying about Om.
Now these three sounds, A, Vu and Ma, if you utter these three sounds together, what do you get? It's not O. Wherever there is a realized being, there sound Om will be there. For example, Christianity, it's always said, Amen. You take off the N and say Amen. Oh. Islam, born also in the same region, under the same cultural and language influences, they are saying Ameen. Take away N and say Ameen. It's the same sound.
Don't be fooled, because there is nowhere in the spiritual world that they are talking about Am instead of Om. Every philosophy has a specific symbol for Om. In all the literatures, it is only Om, no Am. There is A plus U plus Ma. It is written that way, but it is never pronounced that way. It is used to explain something else. There are about 50 symbols of Om in India. The Devanagari symbol is very famously known. The Punjabi way of writing in Gurumukhi is also famous. The Tamils have their own way of writing Om. Jaggi Vasudev does not understand this. He simply flicked the notes of Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha, who is also known as Palani Swami, and tries to dazzle the public. However, Jaggi Vasudev cannot explain how this A, U, Ma became Om, and how it is connected to Emin, Amin, and so on. And therefore, Jaggi Vasudev is insisting that it is Am instead of Om to fit his stories. Jaggi openly stated that he didn't know Sanskrit. Then he goes and make blunders by stating that mantras have no meaning. And then he makes profound statements showing the similarity between Om, Amin, Amin. The question is how he arrived at this conclusion. A person who understands the meaning of Om will never call it Am and will never state that mantras have no meaning. This all clearly shows that Jaggi Vasudev steals the notes from the lectures of my guru, Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha, who is also known as Palani Swami, who has been teaching Vedic and yogic science for the past 40 years. Please refer to the link in the description below for further information on how Jaggi Vasudev met Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha and how he started flicking Bhagavan Sri Shanmukha's knowledge and pretends to have it as his own.